Liberate this once peaceful planet from Mizar and his evil drones. Colored gems can be collected. These will increase your health. Beware of Mizar's soldier drones. They remain on Goldwood in great numbers. Though weak, they often travel in groups. Don't be caught off guard by sniper drones. They use the treetops as ambush points. Pick them off using manual targeting. These crates contain ammunition. Collect them to increase your supplies. Across the level, you will find the tribals. This bear-like race has been enslaved by Mizar. Free as many tribals as you possibly can. When you have completed your objectives, find the takeoff pad where your ship awaits. You are now one step closer to Mizar's lair.
Yeah, screw the tribals. How's it going, Red Sun? So my PB for this category is pretty old, so I think I should be able to beat it by quite a bit, unless I like majorly screw up something. Too much of it is cutscene. I don't know the exact numbers. Gotta be at least like 10 minutes of cutscene here. Might be more. Oh, come on. Still not getting the plasma shotgun. Maybe someday. Thank you. think we should save quite a bit of time on this split. Some seconds. Oh, 30. Okay. Well, 24 save, I guess. Yeah. 37 ahead. Is it only... Oh, here, I can fix that. My OBS must have switched back to stereo. I only got one of the sound plugins plugged in right now. Only the yellow or whatever, or the white. I can't remember which one does sound. We'll do it. I'll find time to do it sometime here. There should be quite a few cutscenes coming up. I always check if the sound's working on my phone, but my phone is mono anyway, so I wouldn't have noticed that. So the hardest part about this is going to be remembering to skip the tribals, because I'm so used to getting them now. I'll see if I can kill a few of them along the way.
Ha 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 ha!
Yep, gotta have Floyd. Does that next door even open if you don't have Floyd? I can't remember. It's been a while since I tried. Oh, whoops. I don't need to do that. That's the first time I've done that. I'm sure I'll do that a few more times where I start going after the tribals when I don't need to. Okay, yeah, maybe you're right. I don't think I did, but I had played this with a friend beforehand, so I knew that Floyd was there and I knew I wanted him. So, if I can kill all these drones in the castle quick, that'd be great. Good enough. I think this route is the fastest on this way. If I remember right. Okay, let's see if I can get that audio fixed. Tell me, do you got audio in both speakers now? Or both ears, I guess? Bats. Yeah, he should die really easily if I could hit my shots. I still beat my PB time on this by quite a bit, I think. It's crazy. I must have hit his self-destruct button or something. Maybe he had like 100 grenades that he had eaten or something. Such an epic prank. Oh. Split a little late there. Yeah, he basically nukes Tophrit. Like, that planet's dead. He's next. Oops. I could have skipped that. Oh, come on, please die. Don't know if I need that one actually in this category. We'll get it just in case though. Get in the door. Get in the door. Yeah, are you talking about the Gemini on Anubis? Yeah, I definitely could have gotten away with not getting that one. Kind of just used to that route, I guess. It's gonna take probably a few runs of Mizar 1 before I don't accidentally do some of the any percent routes. Not too far out of the way, at least for that one. Yeah, it's definitely nice to not have to worry about him. I don't remember if my old splits split at that door or at the ship, but I guess either way I still beat it by a lot, so. Oh no, is my screen going down? Did the stream freeze for you for a bit there? I don't know what's going on. Okay, it must be just my end then. My capture is just fine, but like when I was watching the stream on my end, it froze for a bit. Well, that's good then. That's the only reason I get the grenades, because otherwise those guys are annoying to kill. Oh shit, I should have grabbed that machine gun capacity. Aww. Yeah, you get like the full running animation. We'll play it safe this time, and maybe I'll kind of cut out some next time. Still need the yellow key. Or at least we don't need it, but it's good for getting the capacity. Thank you. I should definitely skip one of those capacity ones earlier and just get that one there, because that one's really easy. Yeah, he really does just summon into existence. He's auto-aiming on his grenade there. Okay, there should be one more somewhere. Is there one back here? How did I miss you? Couple more. Okay. Yeah, Vela's boss does have that. Oh, come on. I guess I'm crawling. God. Cannot manage a weapon for me. Well, it's a little bit of a scuffy cerulean, but it'll be fine. I don't even have to run around the ship to get the tribals. It just runs straight in there. It's a good question why they split up. I think we're not supposed to think that hard about it. Hey, your holy homework. Thanks for the follow. Yeah, from talking to people that played this game, it seems like most people didn't find all the tribals. They just got to, they did everything else but then do the tribal thing. And I totally get that. Sniper rifle. that it? Come on. You're supposed to die. That room was a little messy. Nice shot for the tribal kill. Hide him. Okay. Time to platform. The most fun part of the game. Hey, first try. If they didn't want to die, they would just stand there. I mean, makes sense to me. Yeah, I don't know if I know the structure of the Mizar military, but I can only assume the bosses are, like, generals or something, right? Every single one of these creatures are piloted by tribals. Yeah, that's the baby tribals are in the blue drones. There we go. Okay. It's just a flesh wound. Yeah, I'm convinced that there's a tribal inside there, and to stop Vella from finding out Mizar's plans, the tribal self-destructs to get rid of the evidence. This is tribal business, and Goldwood can deal with it. Maybe Jeff and Barry were, like, together on this. Topper will not be dealing with tribal business on the account that everyone is dead. Yeah, that's true. There aren't any tribal zombies. somehow saved 45 seconds there. Yeah, the octopus is different, and you don't... At no point in the game do you have to kill an octopus to progress. I don't know. Maybe I, like, fell and had to, like, restart the area. I, like, fell off a bridge or something. That's the only thing I can think of. This was, like, I don't know, like, probably early 2019 or something when I did this, so... It's been a while. Should I go for the skip? You can jump on this box up here and then fly to the ledge. I'll give it a shot, and if I fail it, I'll just go around. It's a little hard. You have to time it just right. Hey, I nailed it. Perfect. That's great. Yeah, I don't remember if I did that as a kid or not. Yeah, it's kind of a hard one to do, mostly because all those drones there are making the game lag, and when it's lagging like that, it's really hard to, like, time the jump right. I'm honestly really surprised I got that first try there. Probably never gonna do that again. Okay, let's see. Gotta remember not to get the trifles. Or at least not take that route. Okay, I'll get this. Oh yeah, I don't need to shoot that. I can just fly in. Okay. these guys. Hey. That guy just threw me his, threw me his machine gun, so I got the ammo. I feel like I'm out of homing, though. Seems like I usually have homing here. I wonder what I missed. This might be kind of tough. That was a little slow. Yeah, I think this and, like, most N64 games lag. I think this and, like, Banjo-Tooie are, like, the only ones that, like lag in a noticeable way. That, like, affects a casual playthrough. Oh, fuck, that's right. God. I'm forgetting how to play the game. About as fast as I can go with just the machine gun alone in that room. Die. Do you remember last one where I like fell off that thing a million times? Can't remember, were you watching that part? Yeah, it was like 5 or 6 times, I think. Yeah, Etchbone I lost a ton of time on that one. So that's probably one of my bigger, next time I run any percent, that's probably one of my bigger ones I can save time on. I always call them grasshoppers, but the mantis fight is probably always gonna be one of my things where I can lose a lot of time on too, because I can't get perfectly consistent at them. I can get kind of good at them, but... Yeah, this is definitely the hardest boss in the game. I feel like the first time you play Mizar 2, it's pretty hard, like, casually. Yeah, not many people actually got to Mizar 2. And, I think he's really hard, but once you know, like, the speedrun tricks to beating him, he's not that bad. Because you kind of just aim at a certain spot, and you can, like, fire try rockets at him as he flies up and kind of hit him without even aiming at his back. Yeah, the lightning attack is the worst thing. So, like, that in speedruns, if you're seeing those attacks, you're not doing very good on Mizar, because we usually don't let him get to that part of his cycle. Yeah, and it's really the only when he does like the really slow lightning attack does it get really hard, because the other ones you can kind of just jump rope, but that one is like it kind of almost follows you. Yeah, you'd think praying mantises would not want to be around lava. I feel like they're kind of flammable. We got him on the second one. Yeah, that's good. That one's always a tricky shot. I struggle with that one. That's kind of the hardest part of the boss. Okay, left side first. Remember, that's one thing I screwed up last run too, is I forgot that. I did one cycle on, but that's okay. Cool. Down here. Yeah. Yeah, this is one of the longer cutscenes in Mizar. In Mizar 1. Probably still one of the longer cutscenes in the game. I think the Mizar Palace's cutscenes are the worst, but... Whatever. We got him. Yeah, I mean, and for the time, I think these are pretty good cutscenes for N64 games. Because I remember, as a kid, I was impressed by them. Had to think about that one for a second. But yeah, we were talking about the tribals controlling them. Okay, I'm gonna go back and get some ammo, just... safe. Probably don't need to, but I'm a hot dog. I almost went for the tribals. Hey. Okay, sure. That's how I'm doing that room, I guess. Oh shit, I didn't need to get those. I saved them, yeah. I should have killed them. I felt bad because I killed quite a few earlier, so that's my atonement. Okay, no tribals. Nope, no tribals. God damn it. I think it's screwing with my head because there's not really actually that much to do if you're not getting the tribals. I don't know where I... How did I take 9 minutes last time? Because there's no way this is going to take that long. Oh, I guess there's the palace cutscene. I wonder how long that is. There is a category for that. Let me see what they call it. Because I know Canaris and Jimmy, I think, have done it. Which are the top two speedrunners of Jeff for Gemini. I guess they don't have it officially listed on the speedrun, on the speedrun.com page, but I know Canaris has a video. At least I think Canaris did it. Maybe it was only Jimmy. Yeah, I can't find the video right now. I'll try looking for it later in the other cutscenes. I know at least one of them have done it. Oh yeah, I was probably supposed to... Oh no, never mind. I'm thinking I probably split as soon as Lupus goes in the door. I'm assuming the time save there is because I probably ran out of ammo when fighting the big dudes. Yeah, I mean, it feels like half cutscenes. Yeah. The rest of the game after this doesn't have much for cutscenes, but we're only doing Mizar 1 here, so. Yeah, that's just the spot to stand, obviously. They just accept their fate as they rise up into the air. So Canaris actually just taught me the other day that you can skip Vela's flying cutscene by going into Juno and then selecting her and going back in. Which is pretty cool. So unlike N8%, Mizar 1 is kind of a breeze at the end. Whereas like N8%, like the hardest splits are like right at the end. Yeah, I was giving them a good look. I didn't get them though. I held myself back. I found the video. Mizar 1 is super tough. Here's Canaris's tribals percent, or kill all tribals category. Yeah, genocide percent, basically. Okay, and don't have to go through as much of the maze with Juno here. Actually, I can just go straight for this fire pit and not have to worry about the other doors too. Did he actually go and fight Mizar too? Like, did he? I don't think I've watched the whole video. I've watched part of it. So he actually did save the tribals, then he went back and killed them, or something like that. Like, that's kind of an interesting routing dilemma, trying to like figure out when's the best part of the game to kill them all and what's the best part of the game to save them. We kill Barry in our hearts. Oh no, it all comes down to the hardest boss fight in the game. Ledge grab, ass jump. But yeah, I think this cutscene right here is the longest one. In the whole game.
Hey, no, get out of here.
My dog's putting his paws up next to my N64 and he's making me nervous. Because he has accidentally reset one of my runs before. I think anyone that plays this game gets sick of all the cutscenes. But they are kind of nice. Like this one, I always use as a bathroom break in the middle of the run. Yeah, they do use that grenade effect a lot. Yeah, Lupus is the center of attention on this one. Lupus should be the main character of this game. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure. Yeah, I'm not sure how he is able to do that with his dog paws. But I guess he can shoot a gun, so maybe we shouldn't question it. Oh yeah, he is in a tank. Maybe there's like a mechanical arm in the tank that comes out. Yeah, this gets way more cutscene than the final boss. So I think that's fourth place with this PB. So yeah, it wouldn't take much to take third place for Mizar 1. I think third place is 129. Oh no, it's a 128 for a third place. Serenio has. So I can probably get there. I'll probably keep. Yeah. Yeah, don't get those tribals that I got. Yeah, skip Gemini. I mean, honestly, like, there's definitely, especially at the beginning of the game, there's definitely a lot of rooms that could do better. So, I mean, there's a lot of parts of this that I'd definitely do better in my any percent line runs, so. But that's pretty good for tonight. Yeah, have fun at work. Yeah, I'm getting off anyway. This is gonna be a short stream. Brought his gamer set up to the asteroid. He needed to play some League. Anyway, I'm gonna be getting off here. Thanks for hanging out, Red Sun. See you next time.